Welcome to the video lecture series on embedded systems. This is lecture number one. Myself, Nikhil Kulkarni, working as assistant professor in Department of E&CE, KLS VDIT, Raigarh. So, as it is an first lecture, so let us go through the basic introduction of the syllabus. And main thing about this presentation is to cover the introduction to ARM 32-bit microcontroller. So as I mentioned, the syllabus of embedded systems. So if you concentrate on module 1 right now, so it is about ARM 32-bit microcontroller. So in general, if you see any microcontroller or any microprocessor, so in such syllabus, first we start with the architecture. That is how an processor or an controller is designed with respect to hardware and as well as what kind of instructions it will support. Okay, so after understanding these things, we have to go to the instruction, so that is covered in module number 2. So once you know about the instructions, so then you are develop your programming skills. So that may be with respect to assembly or C language. Okay, basically first two modules, they will cover the fundamentals of ARM microcontroller. Okay, so third module onwards, we have the introduction to embedded system components. Okay, so embedded system, so if you consider it as a mobile as an embedded system, so again you need to know about the hardware. So something like, what is the RAM, what is the ROM size, and what kind of applications on which it can run. So few to name here, like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth. Okay, so all such things are covered in module number 3. Module number 4 is about the embedded system design concepts. Based on what kind of conditions the required embedded system is designed, so we shall see that in module number 4. And after understanding all these things, which is the suitable operating system which can be adopted for the required embedded system on which you are working, so that can be understood in module number 5. Basically you need to refer two textbooks. One is Joseph Yu, The Definitive Guide to ARM Cortex M3, second edition. And second one is Introduction to Embedded Systems by Shibu KV. Okay, so first two modules are covered in the Joseph Yu textbooks. Later three modules are available in Shibu KV textbook. Coming to the first topic of today's class, that is ARM, introduction to ARM 32-bit microcontroller. Okay, so if you have already studied about any basic microcontroller or any basic microprocessor, then first thing is you need to know why it is called as something like 32 bit here or some n bits. So if you have studied 8051 microcontroller, for example, it is a 8 bit microcontroller. So here 8 bit, it refers to what is, it can handle a data of 8 bits per cycle. So this is decided by the capacity or the value of the data bus. If data bus is 8 bit, we can call it as a 8 bit microcontroller or microprocessor. If it is 16 bit, if it is 32 bits, it can be called as 32 bit microcontroller or microprocessor. So right now we have ARM 32 bit microcontroller. So it means what? It can handle a 32 bit data in a given cycle at a time. Okay. Now coming to what is ARM. So ARM is a 32 bit reduced instruction set computer instruction set architecture developed by ARM Holdings. It was named as the Advanced RISC machine, and before that it was known as Acorn RISC machine. Okay, so here we have two things. One is RISC, so which stands for reduced instruction set computer. So there is another version called as CISC, complex instruction set computer. So a very specialty of RISC based machines are, here you can use any register for performing all operations, or you can also say that any register can be used with respect to all the instructions. So that means in case of CISC based, so there will be some kind of register called as accumulator, which must be used for all the ALU operations. So here we don't have such restrictions. So that is the meaning here. Okay. And basically ARM, it stands for Advanced RISC Machine. Okay. So as I mentioned earlier, it was also known as Acorn RISC Machine. Next, what is the ARM Cortex M3 processor? So we know ARM is the Advanced RISC Machine, whereas it has the version called as Cortex M3 processor. The first of Cortex generation of processors released by ARM in 2006. And it was primarily designed to target a 32-bit microcontroller market. Okay. So right now you need to understand here that what we are studying is a Cortex M3. It is a 32-bit processor. Okay. So it is not a controller. So it means what here? So basically, if you consider a microcontroller for your reference, so a microcontroller will be having a CPU within that, and as well as memory unit and some other units also. Okay, so all these things are embedded or fixed or packed in a single chip. So that means you cannot modify the features. So something like, if the RAM is like 512 KB, you cannot extend it to something like 1 GB or 500 MB like that. Okay, so whatever things are there, they are fixed, you cannot change it. Okay, but whereas if you consider a microprocessor in the same way, if you consider the microprocessor, so in case of microprocessor, again we will be having the CPU, but other peripherals like memory or any other unit, it is connected through the bus interface. Here, say for example, if you have some system with 2 GB of RAM, so if you want to upgrade it to 4 GB of RAM, depending on the features supported by the CPU, you can change that. So that is the main difference between the microcontroller and a microprocessor. Okay, so as I told, it is not only limited to changing the RAM only, it is just an example for your understanding. Okay, now let us understand few background about the ARM. So ARM was formed in 1990s as Advanced RISC Machines Limited, so which was developed as a group of three companies, we can say. One is Apple Computer, second one is Acorn Computer Group, and VLSI Technology. In 1991, ARM introduced the ARM 6 processor family. So it was initially licensed by VLSI. Okay, so subsequently, so few other companies, they also joined with the ARM. So name to few here is Texas Instruments, in short we call it as TI. So something like NXP, now it is taken by Philips. Okay, so this thing you can understand in the programming. So if you have used the Keil Microvision software, so there you will come to know, while selecting the device, you will go to options for target. So under that, you need to select on which board you are working on. Say for example, if you are using 8051, so the 8051 vendors can be Intel, Atmel, like that. So if you are using Atmel, so very popular series in Atmel is 8089C51 or 52, right? So these are the different vendors. Okay, so continuing the same, the main thing is ARM does not manufacture processor or sell the chips directly. So here one thing is clear, that ARM will not, it is not in the manufacturing job. Instead, what they do is they provide the license to the designers. It is just like a small example to give it to you is, so here it is like, say for example, if you have designed something which is very unique, okay, but that design is required as a basic design in generating the required unit. Okay, so something like a processor, if you have the design with you, okay, so if others want to design it, means others want to manufacture it, so you will give your design to them and you will give the license to them to manufacture the hardware based on your design. Okay, so something like, now right now we have something like punch hole cameras on the screen. So if it was designed earlier by some XYZ company, so if other company needs to use that design, so they need to take the license from the original designer to include that design in their manufacturing devices. Okay. Then another thing is the ARM based design are very low cost and much power efficient processors. Okay. Then if you look into this figure over here, so it will describe the Cortex M3 processor versus the Cortex M3 based microcontroller unit. So as I told you earlier, so if you have any ARM microcontroller, that is Cortex series, M3 series, so that means the CPU or the microcontroller will be having the processor or a CPU which is based on the design provided by Cortex M3 microprocessor. Okay, so other than that, other peripherals will be independent of Cortex M3 processor. Also, all those things are embedded on a single chip, but they need to get the license to use that. Okay, next. So as I mentioned earlier, so there are various architecture versions. So it was started from a classic processors, followed by ARM Cortex A processors, R processors and M processors. So development of ARM architecture, it was started with version 4T, then followed by version 5TE, then version 6 and version 7. Okay. So our intention is, or right now what we are studying is about version 7. We are studying version 7, but under that we need to study the Cortex M3 series. So that means version 7 Cortex M stands for microcontroller. So under this we are studying one of the family called as Cortex M3. Okay, so we no need to give much importance here. Once we go to the instruction set, you will come to know there. Okay, so ARM Cortex processors, so as I told you earlier, Cortex A series, it is designed for high performance open application platforms. Cortex R series, they are designed for high end embedded systems in which real time performance is needed. And M series is used deeply embedded microcontroller type systems. So high performance open application platform means something like a server, if you take something like a financial server, banking system server. So there you need a very high end processors which will work 24/7. Okay, Cortex R series meant for what now? Real time performance. So you can imagine like a missile system or a satellite system which are intended for a time bounded conditions. So M series means deeply embedded. Deeply embedded means along with the processor, very much other peripherals can also be embedded compared to a normal microcontroller. Okay. So how ARM evolved? So as we need to study this one, so as it was given in the previous picture, so here it is the same thing. So they started with version 4 and version 4T, then version 5 and 5E, then version 6 and version 7. So classic processors, if you consider, shown in blue color, light green will show embedded Cortex processor families. Application oriented are shown in orange color. Okay, so we are studying the embedded Cortex processors, Cortex M3 processor. Okay. So after all deciding about all these things, instruction set development was taken into account. So historically, since ARM 7TDMI, so if you consider, there are two different instruction sets are supported on the ARM processor. One is referred as, in fact, the ARM instruction or ARM mode. So another one is referred as thumb mode. Okay. So all ARM instructions So if you are working in ARM mode, so all instructions are 32-bit instructions, right? So whereas thumb mode means all are 16-bit instructions, okay? So that is the meaning over this. So one more feature here is what they introduced is during the programming, the processor can be dynamically switched between ARM state to thumb state or vice versa. Okay, that means if you are operating on a 32-bit data, so if you want to switch to 16-bit data, so there is a separate thing which can be adopted. So that we shall see in the coming lectures, that is in the module number 2, once we take the instruction set. Right now you remember the meaning of ARM mode, that is, it means it is a 32-bit instruction mode. Thumb mode means it is a 16-bit. Okay. Now, if you have something like small example like move instruction, if you are using it in ARM mode or in thumb mode, in ARM mode, it can handle how many bits? 32 bits. In thumb mode, you can use 16-bit data. Then comes the instruction set development continuation. So depending on the different architectures, so different kind of modes were used. But in 2003, ARM announced the Thumb 2 instruction set. This is very important, which is a new superset of thumb instructions that contains both 16-bit and 32-bit instructions. Okay, so there is no need to switch between 16-bit to 32-bit. You can use a single instruction to execute both 16-bit as well as 32-bit instruction. Okay, this is the overall thing. So we shall continue with the thumb 2 instruction set in the next lecture. So the reference is text 1, chapter 1, under that, the definitive guide to ARM Cortex M3. Thank you.